So we're going to start right away. Can you remember me, guys? What did we talk about last class? ¿Recuerdan que vimos la clase anterior? Can you remember what did we talk about last class? Wake up, guys. What did we talk about last class? ¿Qué vimos la última clase? Thank you, Digna. We talk about verb patterns. Don't forget that in some cases, with the specific verbs, you're going to use the next verb with the ending in ing, or in some cases, you're going to use, let me share the Blackboard with you. So in some cases, as I was saying, last class we were discussing a little bit about verb patterns, right? So in some cases, you're going to use a specific verb. And this verb is going to be followed by another verb with the ending in ing. For example, when you use verbs such as, let me write over here, the verb, for example, imagine can be, or the verb start. Or the verb stand. Let's just write three over here. In these cases, we're going to use the next verb with the ending in ing. I'm going to write later on. So let me write the other pattern that we have right here. In some other cases, we were saying that with a specific verbs, you're going to use the next verb, but it's going to be separated with this particle. It means that it's going to be in an infinitive way, right? Vamos a tener un verbo seguido del infinitivo, es decir, de otro verbo en su forma original y va a estar separado por la partícula to. Es decir, tenemos to plus the other verb. Este sería el caso de verbos como, por ejemplo, seem. Let me just accept the rest of your classmates. Okay, there they are. Seem. We have the verb expect. And we have the verb, for example, and in some cases, we have a bonus. We can say we have a bonus because we can use either of those forms. It means that the verb can go with another verb in ing. Or we can use the particle to plus the verb. Okay, so we have both options. En algunos casos teníamos, como mencionábamos la clase anterior un poco, esos verbos que sirven para nosotros como un bonus, ¿no? Porque podemos nosotros utilizar con cualquiera de las dos formas. En algunos casos no cambia el significado y en otros sí. ¿Sí? Love, we have like, and we have hate. Let's put it right here. Estos irían con igual significado, same meaning. Es decir que cualquier oración, ya sea que utilicemos el verbo love, like o hate, seguido de otro verbo. El otro verbo puede estar con terminación ing o separado con la partícula to, que va a tener el mismo significado. Pero hay otros casos en los que nos vamos a encontrar con que podemos utilizar ambas formas, pero el significado va a cambiar. Y eran verbos como el verbo try, teníamos el verbo remember, teníamos el verbo stop y otros más, ¿verdad? En esto sí cambia el significado. Meaning changes. Don't forget this. This is like a small summary of last class. Aquí tenemos como una pequeña, un pequeño resumen de la clase anterior. Can you guys help me making a sentence, please? Ayúdenme haciendo una oración. Una oración. Elijan uno de los verbos que tenemos en paréntesis. No se olviden de seguir la regla. Por ejemplo, si en la primera ustedes eligen el verbo imagine, ¿sí? Este verbo sería, sorry, el verbo principal, es decir, nuestro verbo número uno. Y el siguiente verbo que acompaña a este imagine, por esta regla, tendría que ir acompañado de la terminación ing. Por ejemplo, I imagine me dancing with my husband. ¿Ok? Me imagino a mí bailando. ¿Sí? So, choose any verb you want. Van a elegir cualquier verbo, el que ustedes decidan. Y me van a ayudar a hacer una oración. You can write a sentence in the chat box of Zoom. Y pueden ir escribiendo la oración en el chat de Zoom para ir leyendo su oración. Come on. Vamos recordando un poco de la clase anterior, chicos. Choose the verb you like, el verbo que más les llame la atención. Vamos escribiendo oraciones. Siguiente verbo va a ir con ing. El verbo que vaya después de imagine o después de start o después de spend.
Okay, teacher, thank you.
Okay, here we have Sabrina nos dice, they enjoy doing yoga, very good. They decide to eat vegetables, nos dice Vicky. Okay, I have two examples here. Let me write them down. And let's go to the second one. Vicky nos ponía, she decided. Very good. Let's see, I imagine living alone in the future. That's a good one, Lisbeth. Very good sentence. I hate spending money on unnecessary things. Very good, Laura. So Laura gave us one sentence with hate. I hate spending. Okay. Good. I love playing soccer, nos dices. Excellent. I start to see a series. Okay, that's a good one. Anderson, so we have I start. In that case, you could use I start. To see series, okay. I can't imagine leaving home without my cell phone. That's a good one, Nancy. No me puedo imaginar salir de la casa sin celular, right? Classmates and hey, I tried to do my homework. Yes, so in some cases, very good. What we need to do in these cases is to remember the structure or at least the list of the verbs we can use in each case. Sí, sí es importante al menos recordar unos tres, cuatro, los verbos que más utilicemos en cada uno de estos patrones. Y para no tener problemas luego. So, excellent guys. This is more or less a little bit of the last class topic. Este es un poco de lo que vimos la clase anterior. And now I think it's time for us to start with the next unit. This unit is unit 1C. And I have a question for you. Have you ever get lost? What happened? Where was it? Or how did you feel? Have you ever get lost? Or maybe have someone of your family or friends got lost anytime? What do you say? Can you remember maybe a time when you got lost? What do you say? ¿Alguien alguna vez se ha perdido? Maybe taking the wrong bus. Or maybe you took a different way and it wasn't the right one. Tell me, guys. Sabrina, have you ever get lost?
Yo, teacher.
¿Qué pasa, Anderson? Tell us.
A ver.
Something happened to your microphone. Se te escucha como un poco lejos.
Ah. Yeah. Ay, sí me escucha, teacher.
Yes.
Yeah, a ver, sería, I got lost. I'm going to university because I feel asleep.
You were asleep in the bus?
Asleep in the bus.
Mm-hmm. And where did you end? ¿Dónde terminaste?
¿Cómo se dice? In the en el mercado mayorista, in the market.
Okay, you end.
¿Así?
You end
sí.
In the market. Oh my god, you sleep a lot. You passed more than two steps. Quedó parado más de dos paradas, Anderson. Se quedó dormido. Okay, it happens sometimes. What about the rest? Have something like this happened to you? Elizabeth, que viajaba antes todos los fines de semana. Ida y vuelta. ¿Nunca te quedaste dormida, Liz?
No, teacher.
No, nobody else have got lost.
But I don't believe when I was little.
Mm-hmm.
But I don't remember.
Oh, probably something that your parents can remember. Thank you, Liz. Vicky, have you ever get lost?
No lo sé, teacher.
¿Y alguno de sus hijos nunca se le perdió?
No.
Thanks God, ¿no?
One more in the supermarket. Mm-hmm. Yo estaba pagando la cuenta. Uh-huh. Y pensé que mi hijo se había ido con mi suegra. Y me llamaban de la central, señora Vicky, pero yo no me imaginé que era yo. Así que fui por si acaso mi esposo fue a la central y le encontró a mi hijo con la primita súper chiquitita. Entonces ellos habían ido hasta allá para llamarnos, pero así, grave, grave, no.
Anyway, it's very... surprising. Sometimes you feel anxious when you don't find someone you love and it's lost. That happens to me as well with my sister when we were in Colombia. She just ran away and we were looking for her. We were very, very terrified. And I remember that time. But yes, sometimes it happens with kids because children just want to go away, run, or be playing, and maybe sometimes we don't realize where are they. So, yes, that happens sometimes. Alex, have you ever got lost?
Yes, teacher. Because I could find the street or the street.
Yes, you couldn't find the street. That's another way to get lost.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, I can imagine that. Being in a new city is always a possibility that you get lost. Mm-hmm. Yes, guys, thank you. So keep in mind this question because you're going to work later on in something like this. Okay, keep in mind this question. Vamos a tener en cuenta esta pregunta porque más adelante van a tener que trabajar en algo muy, muy, que tiene mucho que ver con esta pregunta. Okay, guys. So, today we're going to notice the use of the two words. The word this and these, okay? We have two words with a very similar pronunciation, but the meaning is different. I don't know if you can remember what's the meaning of these words and did we use them? ¿Cuándo utilizábamos estas palabras? Can you remember when we used to words, can you remember? Or what's the meaning? ¿Cuál era el significado de esta palabra? Sorry.
Teacher, eso o esa, creo que.
Exacto, sí. Sería eso o esa, ¿no es cierto? In this case, esto o eso, right? What about this other word?
gestos o gestos.
Mm-hmm. Exactly. The difference is at the end of each word, right? Let me erase here. Would we would use just esta o esta? Remember that these words we were using in some cases, ¿sí? Estas dos palabritas nos dan, o nosotros las utilizábamos especialmente porque nos ayudan a distinguir número, es decir, una la utilizamos con singular y otra con plural, y también tenemos una relación de distancia. Es decir, que en este caso la primera palabra que tenemos, this, la vamos a utilizar para referirnos al singular, es decir, una sola cosa que se encuentra cercana a nosotros. Y por otro lado tenemos this con doble E, es decir, this one, que la podemos utilizar para referirnos a varios objetos que se encuentran igual cercanos a nosotros, pero en una forma plural. ¿Sí? Este es plural. La una lo utilizamos en singular y la otra en plural. Ambas para referirnos que hay un objeto o varios objetos cerca de nosotros. En este caso, in this case, we're going to use these two words when we want to highlight something. Do you know what's the meaning of highlight? ¿Recuerdan cuál es el significado de esta palabrita, highlight? This word, highlight, is exactly what I did. Sí, es decir, esta palabra highlight es exactamente lo que acabo de hacer sobre la palabra. Es decir, resaltar. Cuando ustedes quieren resaltar un evento importante, una persona o referirse a una persona importante o una cosa o un lugar importantes, ustedes para darle un poco más de importancia, un poco más de peso a lo que quieren decir, van a utilizar esta, cualquiera de las dos palabras, ya sea en singular si nos referimos a un solo evento o en plural si nos referimos a varios eventos o a varias personas. You are going to see later on what I'm talking about. Here we have a small example. We were on this trail. Estuvimos en este sendero, en este camino. There were all these trees. Y habían todos estos árboles. Y estamos como dándole mucha importancia a que había bastantes árboles alrededor. So, remember that this is going to be another way to highlight or give importance, more importance to some people, things or events. Sí, nos permite resaltar la importancia de ciertas cosas, personas. Here we have a new word maybe for you. The word trail. This word means, esta palabrita de aquí, trail, significa o tiene el significado de un sendero. Generalmente lo utilizamos para las cuando vamos de caminata o trotando y tomamos algún camino. Sí, es un sendero. So here we have the meaning of a new word. What are we going to do now, guys? Can you tell me? Let me see. I'm going to ask you. Can you tell me when do you use this? When do you use this? I mean, this word. When do you use it? ¿Cuándo utilizamos la primera palabra? This.
teacher, la this utilizamos cuando es singular de una cosa, persona, animal.
Exactly.
Cerca, teacher.
And the other one, this.
Utilizamos this cuando es plural.
Mm-hmm. Perfect. When we're talking about plural. So, guys, pay attention to the next exercise. Here we have a small paragraph. Okay, here we have a small paragraph. In the paragraph, you can see that there are some words involved. We need to change them. Okay, we need to replace them with these two words. We're going to use this or these. Okay, so we will have to replace the words in bold using these two words. You're going to help me with this exercise. Okay, so I will be asking you randomly, so we can change or replace these words. Vamos a reemplazar las palabras en negrita, utilizando ya sea this or these, cualquiera de las dos. Which word would you use in this case? ¿Cuál utilizaríamos en este caso?
Teacher, hey, cuando es singular.
Cuando es singular. ¿Cómo vamos a notar la diferencia? Porque ahorita les va a sonar igual ambas, ¿sí? This y this. Suenan muy, muy, muy parecidas. El secreto o un tip que les podría dar en cuanto a la pronunciación de las dos es que en este caso, como ustedes tienen una TH, esa TH va a sonar como un... vamos a tener que mover la lengua y casi topar, ¿no? Vamos a topar los dientes y el labio. Entonces, tiene un sonido como de una D más o menos, ¿sí? Tienen que topar su lengua, los dientes superiores. Es decir, this. This vamos a hacer. Y en casa podemos ir repitiendo ese sonido. La diferencia, en realidad, entre ambas palabras es un sonido, se podría decir un sonido que es muy parecido a una IE en el primer caso. Sí, suena más casi como una E, es como un this, this. ¿Okay? Suena casi como una E en lugar de una I cuando hablamos de la palabra en singular. Es decir, tendríamos this. Y el otro, las dos es que tenemos para el plural, sí tienen un sonido muy marcado de I en ambos casos. This, this. Y es muy corta la pronunciación de la I. Es decir, que no nos vamos a demorar tanto o alargar el tiempo de pronunciación. Tenemos this and this. Esa sería la diferencia de pronunciación en ambos casos. So, guys, in the first word. Alex me estaba diciendo, vamos a reemplazar con
this.
Ajá, en lugar de I have a friend, I have this friend. Muy bien. What about the next? Les voy a preguntar y me van a ayudar leyendo. I think that's better. Y a la persona que le toque leer me va a ayudar a reemplazar. Entonces, Alex, ¿puedes leer hasta el primer punto, por favor?
Hey, teacher. Okay, teacher. I have a friend who's always getting into funny situations.
Exactly. Thank you. The next part, please, can you help me reading Sabrina and replacing?
Yes, one time she was invited to this going away party and she ended up getting totally lost and wandering
around a neighborhood she didn't know.
Thank you. So let me replace here. And as we can see, I'm going to put it this way. So I think it's going to be better. So, yes. One time she was invited to go a going away party and ended up getting totally lost and wandering around a neighborhood she didn't know. Miren que nos dice esta parte de la lectura. Una vez ella se fue a una fiesta de despedida, eso sería este going away party. Una fiesta de despedida. And she ended up getting totally lost. Y terminó totalmente perdida. Around the neighborhood, en un vecindario o en un barrio que ella no conocía. Let's continue with the next part. Can you help me reading Dianita anyway?
Yo, teacher. Yeah. Anyway, she finally sees this house with a desk car outside and that's people were barking in the back. Yeah.
Perfect. So we have, let me just down and we have the answers. Okay. So anyway, thank you. Anyway, she finally sees this house with these cars outside. And these people were barbecuing in the backyard. ¿Sí? De todas formas, anyway, ¿sí? Ella finalmente vio esa casa con carros, con estos carros afuera, y personas, y estas personas estaban en una parrillada. ¿Sí? We can see a barbecue there. Do you know what's the meaning of backyard? ¿Alguna idea de lo que significa este backyard? Look at this. Estas personas estaban haciendo una parrillada en su patio, exacto, en su patio posterior o jardín. Thank you, Elizabeth. Yes, that would be the meaning of this word. Then we have the next part. Vamos a ver qué pasa después. Can you help me reading and replacing Cassandra, please?
Teacher, hello. So she knocks on the door and this nice guy lets her in.
Thank you. So she knocks at the door, ella golpeó a la puerta, and this nice guy lets her in. Y un chico simpático le dejó entrar, ¿no? Let's continue with the next. Please help me reading Kumi. He thought.
Claro, teacher. A ver. He thought she was one of his preferred friends. Anyway, she spent about an hour talking to. Y ahora, teacher, también la reemplaza son.
Ajá.
Sería test people before this case bring out a big birthday cake and can't everything. Acabo de una vez, teacher.
Sí.
Yeah. Did she finally release it? It was the wrong tariff.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. So, in this case, utilizamos singular o plural. This or these?
This en primero, teacher.
Are you sure? Lau, do you agree? Les escribo aquí justo debajito la pronunciación. This and this. What do you think?
This.
Acuérdense que el this utilizábamos en lugar del singular y el this en lugar del plural. Si aquí digo some people, algunas personas, ¿con qué reemplazaremos?
Con this.
Con el this.
Ok.
Con el this.
Si me dicen el this, me están diciendo este. Are you sure?
No, no, con el this, teacher.
Con el this, sí. Exacto, con el this, ese sería para referirnos o poder nosotros reemplazar cuando nos referimos a algo en plural, no se olviden. La pronunciación es lo único que nos va a generar un poco de problemas, hasta no acostumbrarnos. En este caso, he thought she was one of his wife's friends. Es decir, que la persona que le abrió la puerta pensó que esta chica era la esposa de algún amigo. Anyway, de todas maneras, she spent about an hour talking to these people before these guys bring out a big birthday cake. ¿Sí? Ella pasó una hora al menos conversando con la gente de esta parrillada. Hasta que se dio cuenta que llegaron con qué. What did they bring? ¿Con qué llegaron a la fiesta?
Con un pastel de cumpleaños.
Mm-hmm, exactly, a birthday cake. ¿Y a dónde iba ella? ¿A qué era la fiesta a la que iba ella?
Despedida de solteros.
She was a going away party. Ajá, se iba a una despedida, una fiesta de despedida. Entonces, ¿qué pasó? Si llegan con una torta de cumpleaños, ¿qué pasó en ese caso? She realized it was the wrong party. Ahí ella se dio cuenta. Miren, aquí tenemos. She realized it was the wrong party. Se había equivocado de fiesta. ¿Les ha pasado eso alguna vez? ¿Y llegaron a un lugar pensando que era el correcto y no ha sido? That can happen to anybody. Le puede pasar a cualquiera. Don't forget, or maybe, can you help me with the meaning of this word? Handles. Do you know what's the meaning of candles? What you...
Velas, teacher.
Cake. What?
Velas, teacher.
Yes, thank you. We're talking about las velas que conocemos nosotros, ¿no es cierto? Lo que ponemos en los pasteles de cumpleaños o cuando se nos va la luz. Yes, some candles. Thank you, guys. Excellent. So, don't forget the pronunciation of these words, okay? Luego les voy a hacer un ejercicio de pronunciación de ambas palabras para no equivocarnos. This and this. Okay. Guys, can you help me please reading the following reading? Les voy a indicar la siguiente lectura. I'm going to ask some of you to help me, please, reading the next conversation. Oops, sorry. Let me, right here is the conversation. So I'm going to ask two of you to help me reading this conversation. I will make it bigger so everybody can see. Okay, Anderson. Anderson is going to read Mateo's part. Okay, Anderson, it's going to be Mateo. Who else is right here? Let me see. Juan David, me parece que sí estaba por aquí.
Teacher, pero ya cambió de...
Está en la misma página, teacher.
Claro, está en la misma página, teacher.
Ok, sí, give me a second, ya les cambio ahorita. Ahí. Now you can see.
Yeah.
Yes, teacher.
Uh-huh. Ok, Juan David, it's going to be Brian, please. Anderson, it's going to be Mateo. And Kim, it's going to be Josie. Josie is going to be Kim. Okay, are you ready to read the conversation?
Remember that time we were hiking in Delta?
When we got lost, that was funny.
Wait, what happened?
We were on this trail and it was getting dark. Then Brian said, where are we?
Yeah, we can't see a thing and we walk off the trail. It was that bad.
Yeah, there were all these three around us and we were so lost. We are thinking, oh no, we are both getting king of scared. We just wanted to get up out of this, out there.
I bet.
And Brian say, should we joke a little? And I go, yeah, I was thinking the same thing. Let's go.
So we started jogging.
And we say to each other, we have got to stick together in case anything happens.
Mm-hmm. Thank you so much, guys. Thank you. So now I'm going to ask you any new word. What new words can you find here? ¿Qué palabras nos resultan un poco difíciles en este texto? What words do you don't know the meaning? ¿De qué palabras no sabemos el significado? Hiking, okay. The first one is hiking. What other word can you find difficult? Vamos reconociendo qué palabras no entendemos el significado. Ya vimos esta palabra trail.
Es dark.
Okay, getting dark. Y les pongo las dos porque juntas tienen un significado. Maybe, do you know what's the meaning of jog? Look at the text, guys. Do you find any other new word? Ya vamos a ver, Giovanna, qué significa en el contexto. Por ahí, si es que encuentran otra palabra que no entendamos el significado, ya la vamos a ver, ¿ok? Let's start from the very beginning. Vamos a empezar desde cero. Remember a time or remember that time we were hiking in Utah? ¿Sí se acuerdan de esa vez? Y eso nos referimos con esta frase. Remember that time. ¿Recuerdan esa vez que estuvimos caminando? Hiking es el deporte de caminar. Generalmente cuando ustedes se van a caminar a las montañas o a senderos muy largos, ese es hiking, ¿sí? El deporte de dedicarse pues a caminar por un trecho largo o un camino grande o tal vez montañas, ¿no? We were hiking in Utah. Y estábamos caminando en Utah. Utah es uno de los estados de Estados Unidos, ¿no? Utah is a city, it's a place. Y aquí le responden, when we got lost sería el pasado, ¿sí? Aquí tenemos, está en pasado. Got lost, el verbo en presente sería get lost. Para referirse a perderse, eso significa get lost or got lost. Perderse. En este caso estamos diciendo cuando nos perdimos, porque está en pasado, ¿se acuerdan? Cuando nos perdimos, eso fue gracioso. That was funny. Why? What happened? Dice Kim, ¿no? Aquí está preguntando, ¿por qué? ¿Qué pasó? ¿Dónde se perdieron? ¿No es cierto? We were on this trail. Estábamos en este sendero. Recuerden que ya vimos el significado de esta palabra. We were on this trail. Estábamos en este sendero. And it was getting dark. Y se estaba poniendo oscuro o estaba oscureciendo. Okay, so that would be the meaning of this word. Las dos palabras juntas tienen este significado de obscurecer, o en este caso, obscureciendo. Okay? It was getting dark, se estaba oscureciendo. Then Brian says, where are we? Y luego Brian nos dijo, ¿dónde estamos? Como ya empieza a oscurecer, uno no se da cuenta muy bien de los caminos, ¿no es cierto? Yeah, we couldn't see a thing and we walked off the trail. It was that bad. No podíamos ver. No se podía ver nada. Ustedes en algunos casos van a encontrar esta frase. I couldn't see a thing. ¿Sí? No podía ver. Y no es que se traduce como una cosa. No podía ver una cosa. Sino más bien que tiene el contexto de nada en este caso. Es una frase. ¿Sí? I couldn't see a thing, or I couldn't do a thing. No pude hacer nada, o no pude ver nada. Eso significa a thing, en este caso. Sí, I couldn't see a thing. No pude ver nada. And we walk off the trail. Y nos salimos del sendero. Yeah, there were all these trees around us, and we were so lost. Habían todos esos árboles alrededor nuestro y estábamos muy perdidos. And we were thinking, oh no, and we're both getting kind of scared. Y pensamos, oh no, ¿no es cierto? Ya se dieron cuenta de que algo malo estaba pasando. Y dice, and we were both getting kind of scared. Y nos empezamos a asustar. We just wanted to get out of there. Solo queríamos salir de ahí. I bet nobody asked me for this word. Nadie me preguntó por esta palabra. Pero esta palabra tan chiquita es un verbo. Bet significa apostar. ¿Sí? Lo utilizamos como una frase para decir, sí, apuesto que estuviste asustado, ¿no es cierto? Ese es el contexto que tiene aquí, ese I bet. I bet. Apuesto que sí estuvieron asustados cuando se perdieron. And Brian says, should we jog a little? Sí, y mi amigo Brian dijo, deberíamos trotar un poco. Jog significa trotar, no empujar, sino trotar. Sí. So we started jogging. Entonces empezamos a trotar. Y nos dijimos el uno al otro. And we said to each other, we've got to stick together. Necesitamos permanecer juntos. Stick together sería permanecer juntos, es decir, no separarse. Van a ir juntos. So we've got to stick together in case anything happens. En caso de que algo pueda suceder, es mejor permanecer juntos. So guys, can you please recognize or tell me where can you find the words this and these in this reading? En esta lectura, vamos primero a señalar en dónde podemos encontrar this. This, es decir, en singular. ¿Dónde pueden encontrar ese this?
Teacher, ahí en donde dice Mateo, we were on this trail.
Exactly, we were on this trail. Thank you, we have the first one. Where else? ¿Dónde más? Ahorita estamos buscando solo la forma en singular. Is it somewhere else? ¿Encontramos otra o no?
No, teacher.
Uh-huh. Ahora vamos por el otro caso. Vamos a buscar el these con, refiriéndonos al plural. ¿En dónde encontramos el these?
Teacher, así mismo más abajito donde dice, yeah, there were are these trees around.
Ay. Exactly. There were all these trees around us. Muy bien.
Eso es todo, teacher.
Yes, there's no more. We have just two. En este caso tenemos solo dos, ¿verdad? Solo dos. Pero de todas formas, en ambos casos nos sirven para resaltar o como que darle un poco más de importancia a lo que estaba pasando, ¿no? So, thank you guys. I'm going to just write down, vayan escribiendo por ahí en su agendita, en su cuaderno, estas palabras y su significado. Luego les voy a ir preguntando. What are you going to do now, guys? ¿Qué vamos a hacer ahora? You have this conversation. And thanks God, most of you have your book at home. Casi todos, en su gran mayoría, ya tienen su libro en casa. ¿Qué vamos a hacer, chicos? You are 23 now. Estamos 23 ahorita en la clase. We're going to work in groups. Okay, we're going to work in groups in order to make a conversation. You're going to prepare a conversation very similar to this one or to this one, like a really small conversation. You're going to work in groups of three so you can make a nice conversation very similar to the one you have here. When you're going to tell us about something or a time when something went wrong. Okay, let me share with you the screen so you can see what I'm talking about. You're going to prepare a conversation talking about a time when something went wrong or when you or someone you know had an accident. That could be a possibility. Try to use this and these to highlight the events or maybe people or places where this happened, okay? So you're going to be plenty of time. I'm going to tell you later why, but I need you to get into groups. And this is going to be, so you will have time to prepare the conversation. Write down in a document the conversation. So you will have to, let me write it over here. You will have to write down the conversation in a document. And you will work in groups of three. And don't forget to practice because I'm going to grade today your conversation. Okay, so the thing you're going to be graded today is not going to be a written exercise, but it's going to be a speaking practice. So write down the conversation in a document, then you're going to practice together with your group. So when we come back, we can see your conversation, okay? We can listen to your conversation. So guys, can you tell me what do we have to do now? What do we have to do? ¿Qué debemos hacer, Grace?
Hi, teacher. Write on the conversation in a document.
Mm-hmm. About what is going to be the conversation, Giovanna? What is the topic you have to prepare for the conversation? Uh-huh, you have to talk about an accident or something that went wrong. Mm-hmm. O algo que le salió mal, exacto. Or something that went wrong. Very good. How many people it's going to be in your groups? Can you tell me, Mafer, grupos de cuánto? Mafer, are you there? How many people is going to work in these groups?
Three teachers.
Mm-hmm. Three people. Yes. Okay, guys, pay attention. But we will try to see each other because this is going to be your classwork for today. Es decir, la parte calificada que van a tener el día de hoy es precisamente este speaking practice. So I don't know if. Let me see, the group of Anderson, Sabrina, and Lily. Are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, Sabrina, Lily, ready?
Comienza.
Es que no me cogí el micrófono, lo siento. Hi, Anderson and Lillian.
Hi, Lillian and Sabrina.
Hi, guys.
How are they?
Fine, thanks. And you're Lillian?
I'm a little sad.
Why? You said something happened to you on vacation?
No, this vacation I was at home, but I was remembering an accident that I had 10 years ago.
Really? I'm sorry to hear that. Who was it? Can you tell us?
Sure. There was competition, and I went with my sister. I went with my sister to see a friend. I really didn't like it because these cars will go off to the road and hit people.
Wow, these competitions are very dangerous.
Your family was injured?
Yes, it was very dangerous. It was injurious. It protect my sister to that nothing happened to them. This was the last time I went.
Oh, I well never you. You had a serious fracture after his.
I know. In race, people get hurt, and this is dangerous for fans.
Yes, I fractured my knee, but nothing serious. The gear, but nothing serious. The gear hub was next to me, was injured, and had her leg amputated.
Really? Oh my God. Her leg?
I think this is a life lesson. Thinking good, nothing serious happened to you or your sisters.
Yes, because not only do I have the memory of that happened, but I also have a scar of my knee that always remade me.
I hope you are well and take good care of yourself when you go out.
Yes, Lilian, be careful. The next time we meet, I will you tell me a nice history.
Well, you guys take good care to go to 444 races. Bye, guys.
Bye, Anderson and Lillian.
Bye, Sabrina and Lillian. Nice day. Yeah, teacher.
Thank you, guys. I really enjoy your conversation. Just a few things. The good things that the content and the length of the conversation were good. You use the words that I was asking for. Just be careful with the pronunciation of some words. Sí, muy bien todo contenido, el uso de lo que les pedí, de las palabras que les pedí y el largo de la conversación apropiado para tres personas. Be careful with the pronunciation of words such as serious, injured, remind me and careful. Just that observation, guys. Very good job. Muy buen trabajo. Congratulations. Can I listen to, let me see if everybody's here. Grace, Digna, and Cassandra, are you ready, ladies?
Listo, chicas.
Sí.
Okay.
Okay. The ancient date waterfall. Hello, friends.
Do you remember the time we went on an excursion to the Elf Waterfall in the Napo province?
I remember what we went to explore this place on a body warm water. So we went to a cave to buy water.
It is true. I already remember when we got to the cabin, there was a man with a very strange attitude that we thought was sometimes terrified.
I was very scared, trembling with fear. Did you remember, Daniela, that I was the first to run away?
I remember we were left there, not knowing where to go, by Jocelyn Field due to a trap near to waterfall. Did you hear?
Oh no, it was terrible. I hurt my knee because I couldn't see where everything was cloudy and slippery. But when I fell, I found this small bag.
I was very surprised to see these bags. I asked to you open them, but Daniela objected.
I was warned to allow Tento to be open because this place already seemed strange to me, and I did.
I thought.
And that's why we never return. Thank you. Bye.
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 Okay, ladies, thank you so much. The length was a little bit shorter, un poco más corto que el anterior, el largo de la conversación para tres personas. Take into account the pronunciation of some words, such as run away, ¿sí? Como irse corriendo, ¿no? Run away. Y un poco, I would say that the fluency you use is a little bit like slow. You need to be a little bit more fluent even though you're reading. Incluso si están leyendo, deben tratar o practicar en casa la fluidez. Si traten de que sea un poco más fluido. Digna, very good. Your fluency. Grace needs to improve a little bit in the fluency. And Cassandra as well. Solo no se paren mucho, no hagan muchas pausas innecesarias en cuanto ustedes estén hablando o leyendo una conversación, sí, un poco más de fluidez, Grace y Cassandra. That would be it. Thank you, ladies. Can I move to, where are you? Can we move to Josie, Diana, and Jenny, please?
Hello.
Jenny. Hello.
Girls, remember the time we went camping to the Cubilte Lagoon?
Of course, I remember.
It was actually a bad experience. It may be. Although at the beginning it was all very fun.
Sure, the barbecue we did was very good. It was exquisite.
Although after the dates came the disgust, when did it start to rain for several hours?
I remember it perfectly. It rained on us with gray intensity and we couldn't find a place to hide.
It was horrible. It was very dark with a lot of fog that you couldn't see anything.
If for a while, I will be very scared all night long.
After all this, camp was not so bad because we got home safe and sound.
I am sure that these moments I will never forget. Thank you.
Thank you, teacher.
Thank you, ladies. Just a few things I really would like to add from your conversation. I want to add something. You were saying that the raining when the day you went camping was very heavy. Cuando ustedes quieran referirse a un día en el que llueve demasiado, es decir, la lluvia está extremadamente exagerada, empieza a caer muy fuerte la lluvia, tenemos una expresión que podemos utilizar en inglés. When you want to say that the raining was so heavy and intense, you can say it was raining cats and dogs. Okay, this is a nice expression we can use. Don't forget. Escriban por ahí en algún cuadernito que tengan a la mano. Esta frase es muy utilizada, van a escucharla mucho. It was raining cats and dogs. Estaba lloviendo perros y gatos, sería, ¿no es cierto?, en nuestra traducción, pero hace referencia a una lluvia intensa, muy fuerte y prolongada. ¿Sí? Entonces, en lugar nosotros de decir it was a heavy rain or it was an intense rain, you can use it was raining cats and dogs. Y podríamos utilizar esa frase. Me gustó mucho el contenido porque me permitió a ustedes darles una frase adicional. Well done, guys. Just a small reminder of the pronunciation of some words. Josie, be careful with the pronunciation of beginning. Dianita, Elizabeth, careful with the pronunciation of squeeze it. And Jenny, the pronunciation of several and all night long. That's it, ladies. Thank you so much. Nice conversation. Now, can we listen to Galito, Majo, and Nancy? Are you ready, guys?
Yeah, teacher.
Okay.
Yeah. Hello, friends.
Hi, guys. How are you, friends? I'm great this day.
Cool. Today is a good day. You know, here's, I was remembering when that time we went to this Kiloptoa lagoon, where we got lost.
It was fun, but we got a big scare.
Do you remember, Galito, that you didn't wear enough clothes and you froze?
It is true. I was dying of the cold, thanks to Nancy, who I wear a sweater and some additional gloves and I borrow.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun because we don't know we were going to have so much fun.
Also, guys, remember the photos that we took? I still keep them.
It was very beautiful. This place was really amazing. Why all its landscapes?
Yes, but they remember my camera and our battery from taking too many photos.
Well, guys, what do you think if we agree to go to this new camp that is at El Bolite? They say it's great.
Fantastic. It would be a good idea because I like nature.
Both guys remember that we already have exams and we have to study these days.
Exams? When we have to take because these exams are difficult? Galito.
Galito,
hello. ¿Le puedo seguir yo, teacher? Yes. Yeah. There's good, nice and good. There will already be an opportunity to go.
If you are right.
Okay. Well, guys, we already have to go to class.
¿Me escuchan?
Yes, Galit.
Perdón, teacher, se corta el internet, está un poco mal.
Don't worry. Thank you, guys. Thank you. A few things. I heard that when Galito was saying that he was dying of cold, we can use something else instead of dying of cold. En lugar de decir muriéndome de frío, literalmente, porque esa es una frase que ustedes seguramente la traducieron. En lugar de decir I'm dying of cold, utilizarían ustedes el adjetivo extremo, es decir, cuando uno está congelándose, pueden utilizar en lugar de I'm dying of cold, utilizarían la palabra I'm freezing. Esta sería la frase ideal para esta situación. I'm freezing or I was freezing, ¿sí? Estaba congelándome. I was freezing. Es decir, que hacía tanto frío que uno podía literalmente morir del frío. ¿Sí? I'm freezing. Or I was freezing. Was, si obviamente estamos hablando del pasado, sería yo estaba congelándome, ¿no? I was freezing. Don't forget about this. And I heard the pronunciation of some words. Careful with the pronunciation, Galito, of amazing in nature. Nature. Majito with the pronunciation of clothes and besides. And Nancy. Nancy también le escuché que dijo por ahí, I'm great these days. ¿Sí? I'm great these days. Cuando ustedes les preguntan, ¿cómo estás? How you doing? En lugar de decir esta, es una forma de responder sí, pero no es una forma tan usual, lo que equivaldría a I'm great these days sería I'm doing good. Good these days puede ser I'm doing good, que también es una buena frase o una forma un poco más informal más amigable de conversar con los amigos, ¿no? ¿Cómo te va? I'm doing good. Sí, estoy súper bien, me está yendo bien. I'm doing good. Take into account this, everybody, not just the ones in the group. Sí, mucha atención a estos pequeños detalles que les voy a añadiendo, no solo a los del grupo, sino en general les puede servir a todos. Thank you guys for your conversation. Now, can I listen to Laura, Juan y Alex? Are you ready, guys?
Always ready, teacher.
Always ready.
Let's see. Hi, Juan and Laura. How are you?
Alex, I'm fine. And how have you been?
Hello, guys. A long time. I hope you are well.
Tell us, Alex, what have you done lately?
Well, I was fine. Although 2 months ago, I had an accident.
What tell you happened?
I fell the motorcycle to avoid hitting this bus. My feet was now here near the bus tire. The people who saw what happened helped us to help out.
This sounds very serious. Tell me, were you alone on the motorcycle?
My vision darkened for a few seconds, and I was with my cousin. He was the one who was hurt the most.
These motorcycle accidents are very dangerous, much more with these bus drivers. So it wasn't your fault.
Yes, they are dangerous, but anti-adrenaline drugs. The failure was both of us. Nobody wanted to give in, and we got closer. We acercled until the almost collided. And what I did was made the motorcycle fall.
Well, I think that in this type of accident, the most important thing is to call an ambulance.
Call you the ambulance? No, because after it was just escaped. It also waited for that nothing else happened to me. Surely being with adequate security may induce burns and scrapes. What I did was after the helping us get out, is starting the motorcycle and went home.
Whoa. Surprising, I am glad no one was hurt.
Oh, yes. You are very lucky, Alex. These accidents are usually final.
Well, I'll be more careful. I already have to go to English class. See you later.
Bye.
See you.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, guys. Nice and interesting story. Wow. I hope it wasn't truth, or is it?
True.
Yeah. Really? When happened? When did it happen? When the
2 months, teacher.
2 months ago. Oh my God. Are you okay?
Justo después de sus clases, teacher.
Justo.
Terminé clase, salí al regresar y casi no regreso nuevamente.
No digas eso. Thanks God that nothing bad happened. You need to be very careful when you are driving your motorcycle, Alex. Just a few things, guys, for you too. A little bit of pronunciation for you. Juan David, tell us, don't forget. Cuando nos referimos a nosotros, tell us. He hurt. For the rest, Good. Alex, also the pronunciation of words such as go out. The vision was gone. Sí, cuando uno ya está bien y de repente tal vez deja de ver algo, podemos decir the vision was gone. Se me fue la visión, ¿sí? The vision was gone. Se me fue la vista. You make a little bit of kind of pauses, un poco de pausas en la fluidez de Alex, pero por lo demás, bien explicado. And the pronunciation of the word injures. Thank you guys, thank you for your conversation. I hope you are better, Alex. I hope you are better now. And let's see, let's listen to Eric, Kumi, and Giovanna. Are you ready, guys?
Yes, teacher.
Yes, teacher.
Ready to listen.
Yes, teacher.
Go ahead.
Hello. Hello, friends. How long without you seeing you?
Yes, since the last time we went to camp.
That was a very nice and fun experience.
Yes, everything was going well until it rained in the middle of summer.
Hello, girls. Are talking about the horrible camp?
Yes, Eric, it was a camp that went a bit wrong, but we must remember it with good experience.
Impossible to forget that day, a unique experience.
I remember thought clouds were the prelude to what was going to happen.
I bet if we go in winter, it doesn't rain. They remember that day was as sunny at the beginning as this day. No one could imagine that it was going to rain.
Yes, it seems that rain would not start in this year. You cannot longer predict the weather.
I had this the mosquitoes that Barrett is thrown over the trip. Friends, remember how cold it was and this with gold freeze your skin, even in the sun.
My feet were frozen.
Where from see each other soon.
Yes, Kumi. I have to go back to my driving lesson, but we can meet again another day and play another trip, and this time everything will be fine.
I am not even going to deny that stumbles down the mountain were fun. These memories will always be in my heart. It was a pleasure to see your friends again. I say goodbye.
See you soon, Eric.
Bye, friends.
Thank you, guys. Just keep in mind about the fluency. I'm not asking you to be super fluent, but try to don't pause a lot, okay? Try to do it slow, but without making so much pauses. Nice work. I heard some words such as frozen, that was well used, and be careful with the pronunciation of words such as deny, seems unique, and a bit wrong. That would be it for you guys. Thank you. And just give me a second. I think That would be it. I'm not sure if Vicky can talk. Maybe she's on the line to get the vaccine as well. So pay attention to the next thing, guys. We're going to move to the last part. Vamos ya la última parte de la unidad. We're not going to take along. So let's try to work together so we can do it. Not super fast, but we can do it in a good time, okay? Pay attention. This is the last part of the unit number one. We're going to move to lesson D. Vamos a la lección D. In this lesson, guys, we're going to pay attention to a small reading. For the ones who have the book at home, please go to page... Los que tienen el libro en casa, pueden por favor ir a la página number 8. Go to page number 8. And we will have just a very short time in order you to read, to scan this reading. Here we have a reading, okay? We have Blind Chef Christine Ha. Y tenemos aquí una lectura. Before we move to that reading, guys, I want to ask you something. Are you good at facing problems? How good are you at facing problems, guys? ¿Qué tan buenos son enfrentando los problemas? Are you good? Are you bad? What do you think? Are you good at facing problems?
Good teacher.
Good?
Mathematics.
And also facing to accidents as well. Alex, también es bueno afrontando los accidentes. So... think about if you are good at facing problems. Maybe when something bad happens, how do you react? Are you getting nervous or you give up easily? Think about these questions. Let me show you the question. So maybe in this way, it's going to be easier for you to know what I'm talking about. So pay attention to these questions. Are you good at facing problems? ¿Son buenos enfrentando los problemas? Do you give up easily? ¿Se rinden con facilidad? Or you are the ones who fight until the end? Tell me, Eric, are you good at facing problems? ¿Buenos o malos enfrentando los problemas? Alex me dice que es bueno. How about the rest?
Yes, teacher, I take them easy.
Okay, you take them easy. What about you, Josie? Are you good at facing problems? Josie or Jane?
Yo, teacher, I take problems and calmly and always look for a solution.
Exactly. You take it calm, okay, and you look for a solution. That's a good thing. Not everybody is like that.
Thank you, teacher.
Mm-hmm. Tell me, Jenny.
All right. If it frustrated me a lot, but I never give up.
Exactly. That's the key. Thank you. Never give up.
Sometimes we feel frustrated. Sometimes we feel that we cannot do anything to solve the problem, but we can always find a solution. Remember that we don't have solution just for that. Para lo único que no tenemos solución todavía es para la muerte. Para todo lo demás, siempre va a haber algo que hacer. You never give up, guys. Never give up. Como nos dice Jenny, yo nunca me doy por vencida. That's the attitude. That's how we need to face problems. Esa es la forma de afrontar los problemas. Sí, no darse por vencido. Very good. And you are indeed, you are the proof of not giving up, guys. Ustedes son la prueba de no darse por vencidos because you arrived to the last part of English. You arrived to the final step. Sí, llegaron al último paso que es level number 5. So, don't give up and push yourselves a little bit more, okay? Vamos a presionarnos un poquito más que ya estamos en la recta final. Now that you know that you are good at facing problems, you take it calm, sometimes not so calm, but you try to find a solution, I think we can move to the next part. In this part, guys, you're going to see this conversation. Here we have a conversation. The conversation you could see on your book on page number 8. For the ones who don't have the book, you can watch it on the screen. Los que no tengan el libro pueden ver la lectura en la pantalla. Guys, you will have 2 minutes to read the conversation really fast. You're just going to read the main or the most important parts. And then you're going to tell me what would be another title for this reading. ¿Cuál podría ser otro título para esta lectura? Sí, vamos a hacer una lectura súper rápida, muy, muy superficial de la lectura y vamos a tratar de ponerle otro título. Ok, I'm going to see the titles you think of on the chat. Ok, so write the title you think it's the best for this article on the chat. And I will be reading it. Sí, voy a leer ya las opciones o los títulos que ustedes le pondrían a este artículo en el chat de Zoom. Ok, so, Giovanna, what do we have to do now? ¿Qué tenemos que hacer ahorita?
Reading the article and write a new título.
A title. Write a new title. Muy bien. Thank you. Are you going to work in groups or individual, Digna?
Individual.
Exactly. Individual. And for this activity, how much time do you have, Alex?
Excuse me, teacher.
How much time do you have?
2 minutes, teacher.
Excellent. 2 minutes, guys. Go ahead. Empezamos. Vamos a leer super fast. Think about the an alternative title. Good. I like the title of Giovanna, Cooking with the Senses. Very good. Interesting. Cooking with the Senses. Cocinando con los sentidos. Very good. Eric me dice, The Taste of the Heart. Wow. Excellent. Sí, muy bien. El gusto, ¿no? O el sabor de que viene del corazón podría interpretarse. The Taste of the Heart. The Chef Who Looks with the Heart. Excellent. Someone who can't see but can look or can see with the heart. Excellent. Nice title, Alex. Very interesting ideas. What other titles can you think of?
¿Qué otro título se les vendría a la mente? I got Giovanna, Eric, and Alex participation. Thank you. Okay, the chef who loves what she does. Very good, the chef who loves what she does. Cooking with feelings, excellent. A blind chef captures the heart of Latin America. Okay, interesting. So here we have different opinions and approaches to this reading. Excellent. An example to follow, no matter the circumstances. Great. Well done, guys. So I keep on reading the titles you are sending. Cook with outside. Very good. Thank you, Liz. Cooking with magic. Excellent, Alex. Great, great, guys. Now, I want you to work in groups. You made a very, very fast reading. And now we're going to work into groups. You're going to get together with your classmates. I will assign you the groups. And you're going to complete the next form. Laura, thank you. Talent in the kitchen, excellent. Food to the touch, excellent. Juan David, great titles. Thank you, guys. So, can you see the link on your chat box? Can you see the link?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Now we're going to move to the next part. You're going to read again all this article and try to think about the right meaning of these words. You're going to see some words that are in capital letters. Okay, we have some words in capital letters. Try to read the whole sentence and guess the right meaning of this sentence. You don't need to send the form, you just need to choose the right option, okay? You're going to work in groups, and for this activity, you're going to have 4 minutes, okay? 4 minutes to do it, 4 to 5 minutes. Sabrina, are you there? What do we have to do?
Tenemos que hacer el trabajo sin contestar las preguntas, no mandar.
Hay que contestar y no mandar. Exacto. Thank you. Las palabras que están en mayúsculas son las que ustedes tienen que tratar de adivinar o decidir cuál es el significado de esa palabra, de la palabra que está en mayúsculas. Ok. Galito, are you working individual or in groups?
Individual?
Nope, you're going to work in groups. Okay, you're going to work in groups. How much time do you have for this activity, Laura?
Sorry, teacher.
Repeat, please.
How much time do you have for this activity? ¿Cuánto tiempo van a tener para esta actividad?
Teacher, no escuché el tiempo, estaba leyendo. Sorry.
Don't worry, 4 minutes, okay? So you're going to get into groups. Van a entrar a sus grupos y por favor vayan respondiendo, eligiendo las respuestas que más crean.
¿Se pone la de colores?
Ready? Let's start, guys. Enter to your groups, please. You can share the screen if you want. Enter to the groups. Oops, Jenny as well. Kumi. Enter to your groups. Okay, enter to your groups, Kumi, Majo, Lily.
¿Tienes las preguntas, Eri?
Hola.
En este grupo de cuatro.
Yo creo que la primera es la de...
La segunda solo vi que era algo, un número.
Creo que era la respuesta, la segunda.
Les envío con todo al grupo de WhatsApp para que puedan todos abrir el link.
Texas se las arregló para su tarde. Solo sus sentidos del gusto y el olor, dice. ¿Qué más dice? Medio que está así, media traducida la. Veamos qué dice el otro. Uy, no, cancelar. Veamos qué dice la otra parte. Medio, este traductor es medio bueno. No podía ver lo que otros estaban haciendo. Estaba enfocado únicamente en mí mismo y creo que eso me ayudó. Me dio una ventaja, dijo. Cuando salí de allí fue la experiencia más estresante e intensa de mi vida. Fue increíble. Ha perdido casi todas.
Recién está entrando.
Hola.
Uy, ya se acaba el tiempo.
Sí.
Don't worry. Try to. Welcome back, guys. Welcome back. Just a few things. I saw that some of you were very stressed because the time was going over, and some others were reading the whole reading. Be careful with the instructions I gave you guys. Mucho cuidado con las instrucciones que les doy. Si el tiempo es reducido, es porque la actividad que tienen que hacer es únicamente escoger las opciones correctas. No leer todo el texto otra vez. Okay, that was the problem with a few groups. So, let me share with you the form so everybody can see the form and we can do this together. Okay, so let me see if you can watch the form. There we go. Can you see the form on your screen? You should be seeing now the form that we were supposed to do. Sí, debe estar en sus pantallas el formulario que debíamos hacer. So guys, can you help me with the first one? We have the sentence, she took those first tentative steps onto the stage. What do you think is the meaning of tentative? Not final, not certain or confident. What do you think are the real meanings?
Not certain or confident.
Exactly, not certain or confident. Tentative, it's the same meaning as Spanish, tiene el mismo significado del español, es decir, algo tentativo, algo que no es seguro, que no es algo ya dado por hecho, ¿sí? Algo tentativo. So the first answer was not certain or confident. Then we have this word. A, que es nuestra protagonista, A, won the title to 250,000 dollars in a cookbook deal. What do you think is the meaning of a cookbook deal? ¿Qué significa cookbook deal?
The chance to publish, chance sería, to publish her own cookbook.
Exactly, the chance to publish her own cookbook. Yes, sería más o menos este cookbook deal es un trato o un contrato para que ella tenga la oportunidad de publicar su libro de cocina. A cookbook deal. In number three, we have, in the cookbook deal, beating out about other 100 home chefs. What would it be the meaning of beating out?
Winning against.
Exactly, winning against. Es decir, ganarle a alguien más. ¿Sí? Ella no solo tuvo el contrato para publicar su libro, sino dice beating out about another 100 home chefs. También venció o les ganó a otros 100 competidores que también eran chefs aficionados. Number four, let's move to number four. I think there are a lot of people who completely discounted me. Discounted me. What do you think? Reduce the...
Did not consider seriously.
Exactly. Did not consider seriously. Dice, mucha gente, yo pienso, I think there are a lot of people, pienso que hay mucha gente que definitivamente no me tomó en serio, no tuvo fe en mí, ¿no? No me tomó en serio. Discounted me. Let me move to... Okay, Elizabeth. Let me move to number five. Managed to whip up culinary masterpieces with only her senses. What do you think is the meaning of whip up? Do you have any idea?
Maybe make quickly and easily.
Okay. Whip up would be make quickly and easily. It would be the first option in this case. Let me sign it. So manage to whip up. Ella se se organizó de forma que pudo crear obras maestras en la gastronomía, sí, de forma rápida y sencilla, ¿no? Whip up. Es decir, podía batir o podía mezclar las cosas de forma rápida y sencilla. Let's move to number six. We have, but she did more than pick herself up off the counter. What's the meaning of this? Pick up herself or pick herself up. Stand up after falling down or recover from a difficult situation. What do you think?
Recover.
Mm-hmm. Recover. Cuando nosotros nos encontramos como derrotados, abatidos por alguna situación, podemos utilizar este verbo pick someone up, ¿sí? No sería recoger a alguien, sino más bien recuperarse, levantarse, ¿sí? Cuando hemos pasado por algo difícil, pick up, pick someone up, es decir, es recuperar a una persona, recuperarse en este caso. Recover from a difficult situation. Let's move to number seven. We have the word drive. If they have that passion, that fire, that drive, what do you think it is?
Determination.
Mm-hmm, exactly. It's determination. When you are completely sure about something, cuando están completamente seguros de algo, ¿sí? Ustedes tienen esa determinación, podemos ocupar that drive. And what about number eight? You can overcome any obstacle. What do you think? Beat or solve a problem or climb over something?
Beat or solve a problem.
Mm-hmm, exactly, thank you. Beat or solve a problem. To overcome an obstacle would be to beat or solve any problem. Es decir, superar cualquier obstáculo, superar cualquier obstáculo. That's right. Thank you, guys. So you did an excellent job in this one, but now it's time for you to understand in a deeply way. Okay? For this activity, you're going to have more time. You will have 10 minutes to complete this. Well, yes, 10 minutes, I think it's more than enough. This time you will have to read deeply. So you're going to read in a deep way and you're going to answer true or false for the questions you have below. You have 5 questions, just 5 true and false questions, okay? So I'm going to share with you this link again. I'm going to do it on the Zoom chat and also with our WhatsApp chat so everybody can have an enter to this link. You're going to work in groups as well this time. Once again, you're going to work in groups and you're going to have, as I told you before, 10 minutes, okay? You're going to read. And with your groups, you're going to discuss if the questions are true or false. It's not necessary that you send this form. We're going to talk about this later, okay? So tell me please, guys, what do you have to do now? Lisbeth, what do you have to do?
Leer, tenemos 10 minutos. Y después responder.
Exacto.
Con verdadero o falso.
Uh-huh, con verdadero o falso. You have the link on the Zoom chat. Ya tienen el link también en el chat de Zoom. Tell me, Eric, are you working in groups or individual?
In groups, teacher.
groups. Thank you. Cassandra, how much time do you have for this activity?
Repeat, teacher.
How much time do you have for the activity?
10 minutes.
10 minutes. Excellent. So let's move to your groups. You're going to work in different groups this time. And there you go. You have 10 minutes to complete this. Enter to your groups, please, guys. Start entering to your groups. Enter, enter to your groups. Okay, enter to the groups, guys.
No perdió la vista en un accidente. Dice que ella tuvo una enfermedad y perdió la vista. Entonces la 4 sería falsa. Y la 5 dice...
Creo que es falsa también.
Sí, yo también, porque les, o sea, yo leí en una parte que ella tenía como un blog y los chefs se interesaron en ella.
A ver, la 3, ella es la primera chef sorda y muda. Creo que esa es falsa.
Sí, esa es falsa. Es
la 4 dice, perdió la vista debido a un accidente automovilístico. Eso estaba acá en el párrafo de Nasa.
You ended, right?
Dile, dile, que me quede sin. Aquí está la teacher. Dile que me quede sin.
Teacher.
¿Qué pasó? ¿Qué pasó, Johnson?
Teacher, soy Jenny. Teacher, se me apagó la computadora y se me salió de la clase y estoy tratando de... ¿Me puedo hacer aquí con Andrea hasta eso para retomar nueva la clase? Porque ya creo que todos están en grupo.
Edmi, sí, creo que ya te puse en un grupo.
Pero no, no me ingresa ahí y no me ingresa a la clase.
This group is group number. ¿Dónde están?
Es que se le apagó la computadora y se le salió de la clase.
Sí, igual en este grupo estamos trabajando solo Jocelyn.
Yes. We're together, no hay problema, trabajen nomás.
Ay, ya. Entonces, ¿cuál fue todo? La 5.
How are you?
Sí, o sea, no, dice, no, I should go in court.
La 4 es falsa, ¿no?
Sí, porque no dice que... por más.
Tiene una...
Sí, porque le hicieron exámenes.
Algo así.
Entonces, no ha sido un accidente.
La última.
Espero perder por accidente. Ay, no quisiera.
Por eso Alex tiene que conducir con más cuidado.
Teacher, yo conduzco más de 90 y no me pasa nada. Esta vez estuve solo a 60. A 60 y...
Hay que tener precaución. A veces no es culpa de uno, sino culpa de otros.
Ahí fue de los dos, teacher. Ninguno no quiso frenar.
Y todavía fue después de las clases de inglés.
Sí, teacher, es que me fui a hacer un par de compras. Y entonces a la regresada.
A la regresada casi no regresa.
Pero bueno, ¿qué podemos hacer? Lo importante es que no tengo miedo. Aunque ya no quieren que tenga notas, pero bueno. Estoy nuevamente corriendo.
Hay que tener cuidado nomás, Alex. Take care. How did it go, ladies? Nice. Welcome back. Now it's time for us to see if the answers are true or false. Let's see, let me share with you the screen so we can check the questions and then you can help me with the answers, okay? Let me move to the true or false part. So, what do you think is the answer for the first one? How won the lot, a lot of money and contract to sell, in a contract to sell her book. Is it true or false? She
true, teacher.
True.
True, okay. True, teacher.
Yes, that's true. She indeed won a lot of money in a contract for her cooking book. Excellent. Let's move to number two. She is one of the three finalists of the show. True or false?
False.
Okay. She was what? How do you know that?
Because she is the winner.
She is the winner. Exactly. She is the winner. She's not a finalist. She is the winner. Thank you. So it was false. Let's move to number three. She is the first deaf and mute chef in the show. True or false?
False.
False. What do you think?
Because she's diagnosed with an autoimmune disease.
Disease. Uh-huh. She is. She has a disease that attacked her eyesight. Uh-huh. Le atacó su vista, su visión, and she was. She had this problem, so she lost her vision, just her vision. Okay. Solo perdió su vista, no el habla. So it's false. It's false. She is not. Just blind, but she's also, no es sordomuda, sino es ciega, ¿no? No puede ver. Deaf and mute. Let's move to number four. She lost her eyesight because of a car accident. True or false?
False, teacher.
False. Exactly. ¿Qué pasó? Ya me dijeron la respuesta por ahí.
What happened? Because 5 years ago, after being diagnosed with Andrea.
Yes. Thank you, because she was diagnosed with disease. Hmm? Thank you, Jenny. And the final question. She decided to call the producers of the show because she wanted to participate in this show.
False.
Why? Why it is false? Why do you consider this one is false? Digna? Can anybody help me with the answer or why is it this false?
Porque ya le contactaron los productores.
Mm-hmm. The producers called her because she had a blog, I think, right? Tenía un blog, me parece, si no estoy mal.
Sí, teacher.
Mm-hmm. Entonces los productores se interesaron en ella. I want to point out or highlight something, guys. You in your houses have the book and you can see this title. Ustedes pueden ver este título. El título de esta unidad es Against the Odds. Against the Odds. Do you know what this means? ¿Tienen algo de idea de qué puede significar este Against the Odds? Después de
contra bien. ¿Contra? ¿Tú?
¿Contra?
Adversidades.
Adversidades, ok. En contra de las adversidades, can be an option. Esta frase, against the odds, se podría traducir con una frase que nosotros conocemos mucho, que en español se puede o se escucha como contra viento y marea. Sorry, guys. Yes, sería contra viento y marea, against the odds. Si Sí, es una frase que se utiliza mucho cuando ustedes están atravesando alguna adversidad y logran salir o solucionar ese problema. ¿Sí? Against the odds, contra viento y marea. Let's end, guys, with these questions. You're going to read two questions and you're going to help me answer these questions. What do you think? Do you think that this lady, this chef, this blind chef captured the hearts of everybody in America? What do you think? What's in her story? Did this story catch your attention? ¿Les llamó la atención? ¿Les movió el corazón esta lectura? Or you were like, ah, oh, it's just a blind chef. It doesn't matter. What do you think?
Yes, teacher, I think because of her ability not to give up.
Exactly, she didn't give up. So that's something that can motivate us, can make us think that we are wealthy. We are wealthy and we can do a lot of things. Sometimes the first or the main limit is our mind. Generalmente el mayor de los límites lo ponemos nosotros mismos, está en nuestra mente. Miren cómo una persona ciega totalmente se convirtió en una de las chefs más famosas de un show, ¿no? So, it's very an interesting reading. Look at the second question we have right here. We have, after losing her vision, what did this lady try to do in the kitchen? What did she do after losing her sight? ¿Qué hizo justo después de que perdió la vista? Can you remember? She go home and start crying and crying, or what did she do?
She tried to make sandwiches.
Mm-hmm. She tried to make her first sandwiches. So she tried to move on. Trató de seguir adelante, ¿no? She tried to cook by herself. A pesar de estar ciega, trató de cocinar por ella misma. She made some sandwiches. So that's something very significant, right? She is not giving up. Eso quiere decir que no se dio por vencida. And we have the third question. What do you think this chef means when she says people have it in themselves? People have it in themselves. ¿Qué significará esta frase? You have this phrase at the last paragraph, guys. Está en el último párrafo esa frase. Yes, that's the answer. So I just want people to realize that they have it in themselves if they really want to. Es decir, que está dentro de nosotros mismos. La respuesta, la solución o la posibilidad de avanzar. Sí, a eso se refiere. When someone or have it in themselves. Okay, guys. So, I want you that at home, please look for the next, in the next page on page 9, you have a paragraph. In this paragraph, you have, look at this. I don't know if I'm sharing with you the right screen. Let me see. There you go. In this screen, you can see a small structure when you want to write a story or you want to tell an anecdote to someone. Okay, so try to follow these steps. First, when you want to talk about the story or something you have been maybe in the past, you have experienced in the past, you can use this structure when you want to tell a story. First, try to set the time or the place where this anecdote happened, okay? So set the general time or place, explain when did it happen or where it happened. Then you can keep on talking something more particular, something more deep, ¿sí? Ya vamos de lo general a algo un poco más específico. Esta vez ya pueden ustedes en el segundo párrafo pueden hablar un poco de forma más particular sobre cuándo sucedió este evento o esta historia o dónde sucedió esta historia. Try to describe what happened, ¿sí? Describan lo que sucedió, qué fue lo que ocurrió. And at the end of a story, if possible, link the events that happened before in the past with the present. Para finalizar, cuando ustedes están hablando de una anécdota o de una historia que sucedió algún tiempo atrás, para terminar de contar esta historia, traten como de enlazar lo que sucedió en el pasado, es decir, este evento o esta anécdota, con los eventos que están sucediendo hoy en día. Es decir, tal vez por qué nos acordamos de ese accidente o cuál va a ser su respuesta o su solución hoy en día, si van a continuar de la misma forma. Something like that, okay, guys? So, please, Alex, can you help me reading this paragraph, my biggest challenge? Help me reading these, Alex.
Teacher, excuse me again. My biggest challenge. When I was in high school, chemistry was a good subject, but I wasn't very good at it. One day, the teacher asked us to give a speech about chemistry in our everyday lives. On the day of the speech, I was extremely nervous and remember looking at all the teacher's face and wanting to run away. It was a big challenge for me to make that speech, but it helped me become much more confident.
Okay, thank you. So here you can see some of the parts that you can find in an anecdote or a story. Tenemos aquí una historia muy cortita of or about the biggest challenge. Do you know what's the meaning of a challenge? What's the meaning of this word?
Reto.
Mm-hmm. El reto más grande, ¿no es cierto? My biggest challenge, el reto más grande que he tenido que atravesar. So be careful on this structure in this example because you will have to do something similar for next week. Sí, algo muy similar vamos a hacer para la siguiente semana. What do you have to do, guys? You will have to start with your writing. This time, this week, you have your writing number one. In this writing, you're going to make a small blog article similar to the one you have on the book, and you're going to talk about a time in your life when you had to face a challenge, okay? So think about the challenges you have been through. Piensen en todos los retos que han tenido que superar, tal vez ingresar a la universidad, sacar la licencia, cambiarse de ciudad, no sé, cualquier reto que hayan atravesado. Think about how you faced that challenge. ¿Cómo ustedes lograron superar ese reto? How did you feel? ¿Cómo se sintieron? Piensen también si alguien les ayudó. Did someone help you to go through this? Si alguien les ayudó a superar este reto. And how did you feel afterward? Es decir, ¿cómo se sintieron una vez que ya lograron superar ese reto? Compartirme y van a escribir sobre su reto en este link de Padlet. Anyway, I will share with you this document. Les voy a compartir el documento para que no tengan ningún problema. Y ustedes ya saben cómo trabajamos con el Padlet. Es decir, que una vez que ustedes abran el link, se van a encontrar con la pantalla del Padlet que tienen ahí y van a poder, pues, escribir su participación. La primera participación que van a encontrar va a ser el ejemplo. Es decir, que les voy a subir este pequeño blog que tienen ahí en el libro, porque sé que no todos tienen el libro físico y tal vez se les pueda un poco dificultar el recordar la estructura. So I'm going to share this with you. Let me show you. A ver, les comparto en este momento. Example, let's here. Y cualquier persona puede ver el ejemplo para escribir su participación. So this would be the writing we have for this week. Ese sería el trabajo para esta semana. Something else, guys. Las personas que falten de subir la evidencia de la conversación de hoy, do it now. Suban pronto, por favor. That would be the difference. Esa es una de las diferencias que tenemos. Los videos van a subir un poco más el puntaje porque estamos trabajando con speaking y es algo que podemos ver y escuchar con mayor facilidad que lo hagan ustedes y no el traductor. Los videos van a tener un porcentaje de 0.6. Y 0.6 que ya nos da un poquito, nos eleva un poco más el puntaje de videos. Los trabajos escritos permanecen. Trabajos escritos como el que tienen esta semana van a permanecer en 0.3 puntos cada uno, ¿sí? Recuerden que hasta la mitad del semestre vamos a hacer dos trabajos escritos. Then we have the platform. Todo lo que es la plataforma de Cambridge va a tener un 1.5 de peso en la nota. Lo mismo los trabajos en clase, ya sean classwork o speaking practice, como lo que hicimos el día de hoy. Tienen las video activities. Acuérdense que esas video activities son súper fáciles y rápidas de hacer. No les va a tomar más de 10 o 15 minutos hacer estas video activities y hacerlas todas. Sí, hacerlas todas. Es decir, que si la hacen, por ejemplo, este fin de semana, ya tendrían ganado 0.3 a la nota con las video activities. Y el project, este project sí tiene un peso un poco más alto porque es la condensación, se podría decir, de todo. Van a aplicar gramática, van a aplicar vocabulario, les voy a escuchar o les voy a ver en el video que preparen. Sí, entonces ya es como un trabajito, una tarea un poco más elevada, más desarrollada. Y finalmente, pues tenemos nuestro midterm exam, que es el examen de medio semestre, que se mantiene con el puntaje de 3 puntos. Esa es básicamente la forma de calificación de este semestre. No hay mayor cambio salvo el project. Si tienen alguna duda o pregunta, pueden hacerla, chicos. Sí, siempre es una buena idea reforzar con las tutorías. Son 2 horas extra que pueden por ahí ingresar y hacer cualquier pregunta de algo que no hayan entendido, que no les haya quedado claro o que quieran reforzar. Any questions, guys? ¿Dudas o preguntas? No questions.
For me, no, teacher.
Okay. ¿Qué tenemos que hacer para la siguiente semana? What do you have for next week, Sabrina? What is your homework?
Tenemos un writing in Padlet.
Exactly. Thank you. You